Oh my god, it's got 11,000 likes.
The fact that I went from this to this just really shows you that anything is possible.
So we've got up around 1,400 followers in 3 days, which is kind of good. You're like a blind mouse.
Hi everyone, it's me. There's been a little glitch in the system. Yeah. Bye. Hi everyone, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. So basically, I went out last night. What time did I go to bed? No one really knows. What time did I wake up? I'm still asleep. In my head, how my week were gonna go, I was gonna film this video for the full week, sit down at the end of it, do the intro and outro, tell you what the hell happened and the progress of this social experiment. But then obviously there were a little glitch, a little mishap, a little bump in the
road.
I don't know what's more ironic, the fact that this entire video I looked rich and now I just look like rock bottom. So it can only go up from here. How did I start that sentence? For today's video, I thought it'd be a fun and fresh idea, you know, to start pranking you guys on Instagram. I've been seeing so many videos of people faking vacations and faking a bunch of different things. However, I didn't see anyone on Instagram pretend to be rich. At least not honestly, because I feel like a lot of people get rich by doing this. And now we've hit a wall. I guess it can only go up from here, you know. Drake once said, start from the bottom, now we're here. And Miley Cyrus also said,
it's the climb.
Miley Cyrus said that, but then she also said, everybody makes mistakes.
Everybody has those days.
This is one of them. Freezing outside, which is why I look like this. Hi everyone. So as you will have seen in the last clip, today we went out and took photos. I've literally just got back in from doing all that. Throughout the rest of this video, I'm actually going to show you how I edited the photo from A to B. However, because we were out on Oxford Street and stuff, we ended up going to Selfridges to a cafe and sitting there whilst everyone did some work. I actually had to edit the photo super quick on my phone, and then my phone actually died. So before my phone did die and before I got on the tube, I really quickly posted this photo right here, and it's the first time I'm gonna actually read the comments and look through it since I uploaded it. So without further ado, just to get the ball rolling, as this is the first time I'm gonna be doing this week, I also did a few Instagram stories. So the first one I posted, which has got 2,000 views in 54 minutes, actually is a boomerang of the two bags, which I really, really want. The next one says, the question is, do I do it? And then a poll, and it's a different set of bags, but from the same collection. I then followed that up by saying, I'm about to spend way too much money in this place, help. And then I tagged Louis Vuitton again. So I posted all those stories, and then like half an hour after, maybe like 40 minutes after actually, I dropped this pic on Instagram. It's been up 32 minutes, and this has already got more likes than I normally get in this time. So let's read through the comments. This is the part I'm nervous about, because I feel like people know me, I'm honest with absolutely everything. There is a bunch of comments, like everything about this photo is so aesthetically pleasing, can't relate. Lizzie Bonnet actually commented, someone's AdSense is popping, which that is not correct, so watch my videos more.
And subscribe.
Charlotte commented, okay Byron, we get it, stop showing off. This is already making me cringe and we're already one day in. A lot of people are just ignoring it and saying like, Ava just put, oh my god, we're meeting in 18 days, love that. If you're going to VidCon London, see you there. Jeffree Star, is that you? Daisy commented, just empty bags. They're not empty bags, it's actually Jaden Smith's photo that I photoshopped on top of mine, so I assume Jaden Smith doesn't carry an empty Louis Vuitton bags. However, they're not actually there, so correct. This is the next post ready to go up on my Instagram. I'm literally just gonna zoom in and double check that it looks legit. And she's up, boys and girls. She's up and ready to rock and roll. No one's actually commenting about the t-shirt. People are saying we stan a fashionista, but no one's really commenting on the fact that it's a Balenciaga t-shirt. I will check in with you in a little while. I'm gonna let people like it and reply to a few comments. It's got 215 likes in 3 minutes. So we're not doing amazing, but it's also not awful. Alright, so it's now the next day. I'm about to upload the next photo, which is this one right here. As you can see, I've got an off-white belt on, the off-white bag, and then also some Balenciaga shoes. I've been taking this one today. It's probably the hardest one to take, even though none of it's actually Photoshopped. So surprisingly, I don't know why, but this one was probably the hardest to actually take. And that's it, photos up.
Hi everyone, so it's now the next day. You probably can't even tell because I'm literally wearing the exact same jumper as I did last night. However, I just woke up and threw this on. I'm gonna check my Instagram now to see how the photo went down. I haven't actually checked the photo yet to see how many likes and stuff it's got. I'll have a little, oh my God, it's got 11,000 likes. So this photo has in fact got 11,183 likes. Definitely so far, this experiment is going the way I thought it would. Wearing designer in your photos does in fact engage people a lot more, which is really weird. I never really thought about it. So we've got up around 1,400 followers in 3 days, which is kind of good. Anyway, today I'm going to try and take a little bit of a different approach. I really want to like Photoshop myself in like
a private jet.
This is probably going to be the most challenging one out of them all. I don't really know how I'm going to go about it, but hopefully we can do it, fingers crossed. I'm just looking now on my phone. If we actually can find any photos of private jets anywhere that look reasonably easy to Photoshop, because so far, I do not own a private jet, you know. Right, so I was gonna sit in that corner because it's like next to the wall and like the side of the thing's next to the wall, but I did realize that there's all this shit in the background. So I'm actually currently gonna move this sofa so I can sit like here, because then obviously all this back bit's a white wall. So it'll be a lot easier to like edit out of the photo. And then I'm just gonna get shooting. I have just spent probably the last hour and a half editing this photo, and I am so embarrassed by it. The fact that I've gotta post this on my Instagram, the thought of this being on my Instagram, I'm deleting this as soon as this video has gone up because this is really embarrassing. However, this is the final outcome. The fact that people are gonna see this and think I am trying to be that bitch, or they're just gonna be like, this is so photoshopped.
I think it's because the MCRs look, well, because they are real. Everything else just is so real, but the plane, we all know you're not a multimillionaire.
What I'm gonna try and do is find someone else's like Snapchat footage of them on a private jet, like when you see these people on Instagram filming private jets, like, oh my God, guys, look at me. And then I'm gonna like put it silent and voice over it so it sounds like I'm the one on the jet. This is by far the worst one, let's be honest.
Oh my God, this is literally insane. This is not even real life. Like, look at this. They even have little snakes. I love you.
I'm getting messages from my friends like, what the hell is happening? This is so embarrassing. Like, I really do not know what I'm gonna do. This better work. Like, it really better work. I need to now think of what the hell the last photo is gonna be. Tomorrow is the last day of this social experiment. And apparently I've just jetted off to a different country. So now I need to think past this point, because I didn't really think about this until now. All right, so it's been like half an hour, and the amount of people that are messaging me like, oh my God, Byron, how? People are going back through my photos and commenting like, oh my God, you're suddenly rich. This is so embarrassing. While I'm here eating a jacket potato, living the student life, you know? Oh my God. So the time has come, the time I've been dreading. I have had two people message me saying that I'm filming a video where I basically, like I said, fake going on holiday, because obviously I'm on a plane on my Instagram stories. However, I'm really now scared that everyone's gonna flood the comments with that. Oh my God. It's got 300, 400 likes. Oh my God, these likes are going up fast. In 7 seconds, it's got 500, 533 and counting. It's almost 1,000 likes in 7 seconds. Is that a joke? That has never, ever, like ever happened to me in my entire life. I want to see what people are saying. Whoa. Oh, we stand at a rich bitch. Oh, no. Right, like I do with all these photos, I'm going to sit and reply to a few comments. Hope no one susses me out. And I'll be back to update you. Also, from my private jet thing, I think people have been sending it around to their friends and stuff, because that story is almost on 10,000 views in like 2 hours. And also, I have gained like 300 followers in the past like 2 hours as well. So maybe people are sending it to their friends like, oh my God, look at this rich guy. Or maybe they've been like, oh my God, Byron is such a joke star. This is definitely not real. Hopefully the first one and not the second one. However, quite a few people have followed me from it, so hopefully this photo goes down well. Hi.
Hi.
What did you say?
He's just walked downstairs, because obviously I'm cooking tea for us all. He's just walked downstairs and gone, where's I Byron gone today? And I just laughed straight away. And I went, why, what do you mean? He said, I've seen a picture of him in it looks like a private jet.
Oh, and I went, God.
He's doing a social experiment, right, Leon? It, what do you mean? And I'm like, oh, you know, trying to explain it to you.
Yeah. Hi everyone, it is now the next day. Me and Haz are currently out. Haz is just stripping in the street because this is the dedication we go to get good Instagram photos. She's got multiple outfits. This is the outfit for today's Instagram. I'm going to edit these jeans to be Vetements jeans. I can't even... Are they Vetements? What brand is it? I don't even know the brand, that's how poor I am. Anyway, I'm going to edit these jeans to be super cool and fresh. And then I'm also going to edit something on my top. However, we've been taking photos for the longest time. It's just freezing cold today. So imagine me half naked in the street. Yeah, not a cute look. So yeah, that is the situation. Today is the final day. Today's the final photo. I were gonna do like edit me onto some like tropical beach or something. However, a lot of people were commenting and messaging me saying that I'm doing this I faked my vacation for a week type video, and I didn't want to like make people think that even more. So I'm just gonna completely throw off the whole private jet thing and all stuff like that and just go with a normal outfit of the day photo. All right, so I'm back home now. As you can see, it is time to post the final photo of this entire thing. All right, so I'm back home now. As you can see, it is time to post the final photo. So I have this photo right here, obviously, as you can see. Got a Balenciaga t-shirt on, Balenciaga shoes. And then we also have this photo with some Vetements jeans on. I were gonna go with this one. However, I think I prefer the photo of me in this one with a Balenciaga t-shirt on anyway. All right, the final photo is up. I am now gonna get a shower because we're actually going out tonight. So I'm gonna leave it as it is now. And when I get out of the shower, we'll see what the hell is happening and what everyone's saying. Fingers crossed I don't get caught out on the last day. Bet you thought I'd gone. Hi, still hungover. What's good? Let's just see if this works. I, like I said, fooled a lot of y'all. I think three people commented on my photo saying that I were doing the fake vacation thing after I posted the photo of me in the jet. And then a lot of people were just commenting stuff like, Byron, when did you get suddenly so rich? A lot of the photos and a lot of the Instagram stories got a lot more views and likes than normal, which either means people were like, wow, damn sis, this guy's rich, I'll like his photos. Or people were sending it to their friends saying, is this boy for real? At the beginning of the week, we started off with a lovely 59,600 and something followers. The first photo I actually posted was this, as you will have seen. It got 7,611 likes, 233 comments. It also got 42 saves and 8 shares. So the second photo actually did a bit better. Now, I didn't expect this one to do very well because I don't think, unless you know fashion, like Haz and a bunch of other people asked me if that, like, what the t-shirt was. The t-shirt is actually a Balenciaga t-shirt. For those of you that didn't know, but I guess you wouldn't really know because it's not really splattered with like designer names. It says Balenciaga on it, but in this photo you can't really see it. So I posted this, did kind of fun, did kind of fresh, 8,900 likes. Now this photo is the only photo that isn't actually photoshopped. Like everything that I'm wearing in this photo is my own. The blazer just looks expensive when actually I paid like £20 for it, you know. Love a bargain. And this photo did the best out of probably my entire Instagram page ever. So bitch, this got 12,000 likes. You definitely know I'm sending this to all the brands when they want to work with me. Like, I watch your analytics and they're like, on a regular. The next photo, the most embarrassing thing I've ever done in my entire life. The fact that I went from this to this just really shows you that anything's possible. This photo ended up getting, again, 10,000 likes. 10,548 to be exact. It got 234 comments and 10 shares, 41 saves, 450 profile visits again. And then the final photo I posted, as you can see, I only ended up doing 5 because I started a day late and then wanted to upload it on this day. So technically we did a 5-day working week. Still a week, bitch. Don't come for me. This photo again didn't do as well as the others. We didn't hit that 10,000 mark, but it still did better than my average Instagram photos, probably because I'm wearing a designer t-shirt and designer shoes. Like I said, I did this to try and compare if wearing designer items would actually encourage people to like your photos or not. So if we go back to a photo that I posted on the 1st of December, wearing a semi-cute outfit, kind of basic, but still kind of cute. This actually ended up getting 2,234 likes, 44 comments, and 113 profile visits. But in comparison to me wearing literally probably a designer top or designer shoes, the like that I got on that photo, even though it's still an outfit of the day photo, still a photo of me wearing a certain outfit, just doesn't contain any designer. To then be pulling 12,000 likes, that's 10,000 more people clicked the like button on the photo of me wearing designer. Just because I'm wearing designer. Anyway, yeah, I'm gonna stop rambling on. This thing clearly worked. If you wanna see more videos like this in the future, then don't forget to smash a thumbs up button, follow me on Instagram, subscribe to my channel, and I will see you when I'm not looking and feeling like this. Now it's time for me to check out. Bye.